So you've just set up your Google My Business listing, but you want to know, how do you optimize it? How do you get it so it performs the best for your business and then gets you clients and customers ringing? How can you get the best performance from your listing in 2020? Well, we're going to look at that. But actually, before we go into that, it's first of all a good idea just to consider this particular little short story. You need to go to the doctors. And when you get to the doctors, they give you two doctors to choose from. The first doctor is called Dr. Ask. The second doctor is called Dr. Guess. Which one are you going to go for? Well, Dr. Ask will ask you questions. It will find out what's needed first, and then it will then make sure that it diagnoses exactly what's needed. Whereas Dr. Guess will just guess at what it might be. It will just say, well, let's try this first of all. Let's try that, see if that works. Which doctor would you go to? Well, it's obvious, the answer. And that's exactly what's needed, the mentality needed, if you want to improve your Google My Business listing and get it off to a good start. Stop guessing and ask Google what it wants. And you know what? Google tells you exactly what it needs. Most people ignore it. I'm going to show you exactly where you can turn to see what Google wants, what Google needs. I'm also going to show you the top 10 things that you need to do straight away, because Google wants you to get these right. Welcome to my video. So I'm Zane from Zanet Design, and I help businesses grow on the internet. So if you have a business, a small business, and you want it to get local traffic, then things like Google My Business will really help you. So this channel's been designed particularly to help small businesses and local listings to just do the right things, to grow gradually, and to do it the right way. So if you haven't subscribed already, make sure you subscribe down below, click the alert bell, and then you'll be able to not miss the next video that I produce. Now, at this point, we'll assume that you've already verified your business. Now, if you haven't already verified, there are three in particular ways that you can do that. So I'm going to leave a video for you to look at now that will help you to claim your business the right way and to then get it verified. So at this point, I'll assume you've already verified your business. You've got your listing, and now you want to add the right things and to move it in the right direction. So a bit later in the video, we're going to look at 10 things that Google requires you to do really right from the start. But I'm also going to show you how you can find out what Google actually wants. So going back to that illustration, the doctor asks questions and then the person in need of the doctor would give answers. Well, Google's already giving us the answers to the question, what is it that you want? And I'm going to show you exactly where you can turn to for those answers in a moment. But I wanted to just address another thing before we jump online and show you how you can optimize your business. Just want to bear in mind as well that when speaking to many of my clients and speaking to different ones that contact me about Google My Business, one of the overwhelming things is that everyone wants to be number one. And of course, not everyone can be number one for every single thing, every single article. And I think sometimes we have to hold back a little bit, because Google's made it and designed it so that anyone who wants a quick fix, anyone who wants to get to number one quickly, will probably end up doing something that will cause them to lose their particular listing. They'll find that before they know it, they no longer have their listing. There'll be an email comes through that says that you have had your listing removed. Now, sometimes innocent people have to then challenge that because they've done nothing wrong at all. But quite often, people have fallen into the wrong trap by wanting too much too quickly. So we do need to pace it at Google's pace. And that can mean sometimes 3 to 6 months before you'll really see the benefits of the hard work that you're going to put in if you follow the process that Google requires. It reminds me of an old Aesop story of the dog who was going along. It had a bone, it was happy with itself, and as it went over a bridge on a river, it saw its reflection. But it saw another dog in that reflection with another bone. And rather than be comfortable with its own bone, it then went and attacked the dog to try and get the other bone it saw in the reflection of the river. By doing so, not only did it not get the bone of the other dog, but it also lost its own bone into the river. The point is sometimes people try to get too much too quickly. I'm going to show you the safe way in which you can get the right amount of traction with Google, and I'll even show you how Google tells you exactly what it wants. So let's jump on board and I'll show you now.
So as I mentioned before, you need to make sure that first of all you have already claimed your business on Google Maps or Google My Business. If you haven't, then there's a video here that's called Three Easy Ways to Claim. And this article, which I'll put a link down below, just shows you how to claim it. It also shows you there are cases where you can claim it without the postcard verification. So people ask if that's possible. It is possible, but it's only under certain circumstances. So you'll find that article useful. It's on the website, How to Claim My Business on Google Maps. That's zanet.co.uk. Now, one of the things that I just wanted to mention as well is that one of the key things is to try and view your business from the customer's perspective. So rather than thinking I'm great and I can do everything and why doesn't everyone pick up the phone and come to me, just consider how it's viewed from someone else's perspective. And you might want to just ask someone to search for your company in Google and then to give some honest feedback of what they see, how they see it. If they were looking to have your business or to go to you for business, would they trust it? Would they see the reviews? Would they be impressed? And it's literally just a case of looking at your knowledge panel on the right hand side and going through it and seeing, does this make sense? It tells me the opening hours. It tells me where it is. I can do a request a quote. There are so many things it produces that you just need to think, does this actually help a person who's genuinely interested in trying to find my product or what it is, the service that I provide as well? And that can be tricky sometimes because we're very close to our business. We know our business inside out, and it's hard to sometimes get that in the right perspective. So get the customer's perspective. That would be one of my first things I'd suggest to do. Now, the next thing, and this goes back to the doctor ask and doctor guess, is rather than guessing, go to see what Google says in its support area. Now, Google My Business has got a lot of support as well. If you click on any of the question marks on these areas here, so often you'll find that there's more information, particularly when you log in, there'll be more information about certain things. That's like reviews here. There's information with a query. And if you click on that, it takes you through to their support area. And in their support area, you can find out a lot of information about what Google wants. So they tell you, it's as if you've asked Google, okay, Dr. Google, what is it that you can tell me about what you're requiring? What is it that you want? And then as you read through this, you'll see that they tell you what they want. So for the best results, for example, then first of all, represent your business as it's consistently represented and recognized in the real world, across signage, stationery, and other branding. So that's really important. So this avoids the keyword spamming by making your business title totally fitting in with what people are searching rather than what it actually is. So that's a really important thing. So we see a lot of people being taken off because they've basically, in effect, they've put a spammy title for their business. So it should be a real world title for your business. The next thing, make sure that your address and your service area is accurate and precise. Again, avoiding PO boxes, avoiding ways in which you're trying to get as much area, service area as possible. Just be honest, be straightforward, say the address, and again, avoid trying to perhaps have more than one location if you only got one location. It may give you very quick benefits short term, but just be careful that you don't overly do it and then get banned. And then choose the fewest number of categories that it takes to describe your overall core business. So it may just be one category is enough, but if you find there are other categories needed, then that's important too. Now, how do you know what the categories are? If you go to my website, zanet.co.uk/GMB, so that's GMB for Google My Business. And there I've got this list of Google My Business categories for 2020. And it's a huge list. But the advantage is you can get an idea as to what's out there. So there you can see everything rather than just second guess. That's the current list of what you can actually have. So you may find that by searching on the page, you'll find more than one thing on there that's useful and relevant. Sometimes it's easier to see the list rather than just typing it in and hoping something comes up. So hopefully that'll be useful and relevant to you. Now, the next thing Google does, it gives you emails. It emails you and tells you things you can do. So again, we're going to look in a minute at 10 things you can do, and we're going to look at a couple of really clever ways in which you can make sure you set up Google My Business correctly. And they're really obvious, but it seems that most people don't do them. So we'll look at that in a moment. But first of all, if you get an email from Google and it's saying things like about the COVID affecting your business, then if it says update the business hours, we'll do it. Why? Because that signals to Google that you're interested in keeping your business up to date. If they ask you to update your business description, do it. It takes a few seconds, but again, clicking on these things gives the signal to Google. Create a post as well. Again, update your phone number if it's changed. But by doing these things, you're just signaling to Google that you're very much interested in keeping your business alive. Now, a lot of people, they spend so much time wanting to work out ways of getting the next bone, the next trick, the next tip, and yet they're not even doing the most basic things that Google is basically asking you to do. So don't guess what Google wants. Just follow what Google asks for. And just some other examples, another email. So then when it says 403 photos came through, you know, we got these types of businesses. 90% of customers are more likely to visit a business that has added photos. This is giving you great information. So go to your photos, add more photos. It even tells you what do you do with your photos. A unique profile image that appears beside your new photos, videos, or review responses. Make sure it's unique. Photos of your staff or products, they like that too. Exterior photos so people can recognize your business when they visit. You know, again, have you done those three things? And if you haven't, why haven't you done it? They're telling you what they want. So I know it sounds too simple to be true, but this seems to be that people want more complex issues than is necessary. And again, looking here, three people reviewed your business recently. Get reviews. It's nice to get an email to see that you can then see what those reviews are and encourage reviews to come through. When you do something to help someone, encourage them to give you a review. Google wants you to do that. They even tell you when you've had it done. And again, when you add more photos, it tells you you've got more views. More views means there's more likelihood that someone will then come through. And again, they tell you photos of staff, exterior photos, so the same things again. So just take a bit more notice of what Google's telling you it wants rather than second guessing what it wants. So hopefully that's one way in which you can tackle this. Let's look another way as well. So Google also gives you this view plan. And this should really, if you can, this should always say you have completed all the tasks. Don't forget to check back for more. And that's what you're aiming for. Now, how do you get there? And what types of things can it say? And also, when you go through all these things, if it gives you messages and says things need to be done, then just consider doing them as well. So this is my second tip, really, is look at the view plan and then follow on the process it gives you. So I'll give you a couple of examples. So here, you notice that the complete listing isn't completed. It still wants a description added. Here we've got 80%. So if you've got something like this, work through the things to get this as 100%, and then you can then move forward. So why is it that these things haven't been done until you get this information? Get this done as soon as you can and make sure that's completed too. Here again, this one, add a profile short name. And you'll find that there's lots of other things that needed to be added. I'll give you another example. So here, we've only got 40% of the listing completed. They want hours to be added. Add description, add logo. So these are just telling you what you need to do. Get this up to 100% first of all. Now, once you've done this, the next stage then is to go back to that view plan. And on here, if you click it, it tells you, okay, so you still need to add services, you need to turn on messaging. Now, the challenge is when they give you things like add services, what does it mean? When they say turn on messaging, what does it mean? Well, you just click through and it takes you to exactly what it means. So you don't even have to read up on it. Now, if you want to know how to do these things, then of course you can just click through to a video on my channel, just a search for zanet.co.uk. And then whatever it is you're trying to find out about Google My Business, and it'll probably come up with a page that will lead you to the video. But that's the key thing, is just make sure that you fully understand before you do those entries, because you could end up making a mistake, they then do the wrong thing, and then Google then bans them. So you don't want to do that. So make sure you understand it before you fill that out if you don't know what you're doing. So on here again, add profile short name, add description. Here we can see the plan, add services, add business description, turn on messaging. So these are common things we see regularly coming up as needing to be done. So just work yourself through those. Now I'm going to give you just 10 things in particular that normally come up, and you just need to go through the checklist of these things as well. So let me just give you these. Add a business name, add hours correctly, add the correct category, which we saw, you can see the categories at zanet.co.uk/GMB. That's for Google My Business. Add a description, and of course, make it meaningful with keywords and so on. Add your logo. That's so important, not a photo, the logo. And you can tell the photo that it is a logo by then referencing it as a logo. Add your profile short name. Add a strong description. Add plenty of images, at least 5 when you start off with. Add reviews, get reviews, and of course reply to them if you can with keywords, and turn on messaging. So those are the 10 things that Google really wants you to do immediately when you first of all sign up and claim your business. Now, if some of this sounds overwhelming, if perhaps you've tried this or you just don't want to be hassled with this, then I'm happy to do these things for you. So you can contact me at my website at zanet.co.uk, or you can comment below if you've got a question and I'll try and answer it for you. But I'm here to try and help people. But at the same time, of course, if you want extra help or professional help, then I'm more than happy to give you that as well. Now, if you've already made some good progress and you really want to move on to the next stage, then I'm going to now show you some videos that will help you to then strategize and improve on how it grows in Google's perspective.